My name is Andrea Natale. I'm a cardiac electrophysiologist, which is a subspecialty of cardiology that deal with the rhythm problem. The reason why patients develop atrial fibrillation are multifaceted. So the baseline is a genetic predisposition. So all the people that develop atrial fibrillation have a genetic predisposition, but then they are what we call comorbidity factors that impact on the time of manifestation and also on the evolution of the arrhythmia in terms of how frequent, the type of AF, persistent or paroxysmal. And those are obesity, sleep apnea, hypertension, diabetes, and alcohol. There are very good data that alcohol is probably one of the few recognized triggers of atrial fibrillation. We used to call this the holiday heart syndrome because patients during the weekend tend to abuse drinking, and then they show up at the emergency room with atrial fibrillation. So clearly alcohol is a trigger, probably one of the few, but it's important that patients really pay attention in treating the comorbidity factor. The symptoms associated with AFib are different. People think that because the heart is irregular, they're going to feel the heart jumping around. Actually, the most common symptom is fatigue and shortness of breath. And because many of the patients with atrial fibrillation are older, sometimes they don't necessarily make the association that something is wrong. They think they are getting old and they slow down and they don't sort of seek medical attention. So it's important that people all of a sudden feel fatigue and short of breath, especially with physical activity that they used to do easily before. That should really raise a red flag and make them seek medical attention, because this is the most common complaint. With patients with atrial fibrillation, one of the things we worry about is stroke. The way we prevent stroke is by giving patients a blood thinner. Blood thinner obviously are effective to reduce the risk of stroke, but they also introduce risk of bleeding. Patients are not necessarily able to take the blood thinner for that reason. And one option that we have now for many years that has become more popular is closure device like the Watchman. Close the appendage, which is the most common source of stroke in patient with atrial fibrillation. There are other sources of stroke, but in patient with atrial fibrillation, the most common source is the left atrial appendage. So the device plugs the appendage so that you don't have to worry about clot forming there and then going to the vascular system and causing problems to the patient. This is now becoming more popular to the point that I feel in the future, already now, but certainly more so in the future, is going to become probably an alternative to anticoagulation, not just an option in patients that cannot tolerate the blood thinner, which is the most common situation right now. I treat patients coming from different countries. Usually, patients coming from Europe or South America, they are sort of they are okay with drug long term, whereas the US patient, they don't like to take medication long term. So I think once the data are very definitive that the Watchman can be as good as the blood thinner, I think probably would become the alternative of choice in this country.